Public health surveillance is the continuous, systematic collection, analysis and interpretation of health-related data needed for the planning, implementation and evaluation of public health practice. Public health surveillance can serve as an early warning system for impending public health emergencies, a way to document the impact of an intervention or track progress towards specified goals, and a means to monitor and clarify the epidemiology of health problems, to allow priorities to be set and to inform public health policy, funding and strategies. Public health surveillance is conducted for many conditions, including for a group of diseases collectively known as chronic diseases. Chronic diseases are characterised as human health conditions that are long-lasting in their effects and generally slow in their progression. The four main types of chronic diseases are cardiovascular diseases, like heart attacks and stroke, cancers, chronic respiratory diseases, such as chronic obstructed pulmonary disease and asthma, and diabetes. Globally, the burden of chronic diseases is huge. Today, it is estimated that chronic diseases are responsible for more than 60% of the total burden of disease. Chronic diseases are estimated to cause nearly 40 million deaths worldwide each year, or about 70% of all the deaths that occur. As you can see, chronic diseases are currently the major public health issue. Some people say that chronic diseases are inevitable and cannot be avoided. Nothing could be further from the truth. It is estimated that 80% of chronic diseases can be prevented by changing modifiable risk factors such as smoking, poor diet, and physical inactivity. Although it is commonly assumed that developed and richer countries have higher rates of chronic disease, in fact, it is the low and middle income countries that carry the burden because of their larger populations, poorer access and quality of healthcare, and limited policies to encourage healthy behaviours. Given the burden chronic diseases place on health, it is important that health authorities have clear insights into their prevalence and trends, and the prevalence and trends of the risk factors that lead to their development. Chronic disease surveillance collects data to answer three broad questions. These are: how many people are developing and dying from chronic diseases? How much illness or morbidity is due to chronic diseases? And what is the prevalence and incidence of known risk factors for chronic disease development? And how are these changing over time? These are all very important questions for which answers are critical so that public health strategies can be developed and programs implemented to best protect and promote the community's health. How do health authorities go about collecting data to answer these questions? The methods used differ depending on the question, but in general, death data is typically collected from official death registers kept by national authorities or sometimes by hospitals. Illness data, also known as morbidity data, is collected through surveys, review of medical or hospital records, or from information written on the death certificate. Data about risk factors is usually collected through implementation of representative community-wide population health surveys. Low and middle income countries sometimes find it a challenge to conduct surveillance for chronic diseases because of a lack of resourcing or technical ability and expertise. To assist these countries, the WHO has developed what is called the Stepwise Approach to Surveillance, or STEPS for short. STEPS provides an entry point for low and middle income countries to get started on chronic disease surveillance and to develop evidence on which to base response actions. By using the same standardised questions, all countries can use STEPS information to not only monitor within country trends, but also for making comparisons across countries and across time. The approach encourages the collection of small amounts of high quality and useful information on a regular and continuing basis. STEPS is considered to be staged in that it starts with relatively simple to implement surveillance methods that most countries, even those with very limited capacity, should be able to implement, and then provides options to add more complex collection methods, such as the collection of body measurement data or the collection of blood samples for biochemical analysis, if resources are available and there is a need. Step one of STEPS involves gathering demographic and behavioural information by implementing a questionnaire to people in their household setting. At this level of STEPS, data collected includes core socio-demographic information such as age, sex, education levels, tobacco and alcohol use, dietary behaviour and physical activity, and history of pre-existing chronic diseases and any medications being taken. Step two of steps involves the collection of individuals' physical measurements, including height, weight, waist circumference, and blood pressure. This information is used to determine the proportion of adults that are overweight and obese or have raised blood pressure, two of the key risk factors for development of a chronic disease. Step three of steps involves the collection of participants' blood samples in a convenient setting, such as a community health facility, a school, or a place of worship. Blood glucose and cholesterol levels are tested. By collecting and analysing this, data health authorities are able to measure prevalence of raised blood glucose levels and abnormal blood lipids. STEPS is by no means the only chronic disease surveillance method, and many countries design and implement alternative approaches. For example, some high-income countries use a telephone system where random individuals are called and asked about their health and risk factors. In other countries with good primary care record keeping, risk factor data is collected from physician databases. However, in low and middle income countries, the STEPS approach is most commonly used. For more information on STEPS, visit the websites referenced in Moodle.